सो लाइक इफ यू आर कंफर्टेबल वी कैन स्टार्ट ऑफ विद द मॉक इंटरव्यू.
यस सर,
ऑल राइट, सो आई होप लॉरेंस सर इज रिकॉर्डिंग.
यस,
ओके, सो संगीता, यू बिलोंग टू दी सांगली डिस्ट्रिक्ट ऑफ महाराष्ट्र, राइट? एंड
यस
लाइक इट इज एटलीस्ट इन सेंट्रल इंडियन रीजन, इट इज वेरी पॉपुलर फॉर द टर्मरिक. सो कैन यू टेल अस वॉट इज स्पेशल अबाउट सांगली वेराइटी ऑफ टर्मरिक?
सर, द सांगली वैरायटी ऑफ टर्मरिक इज यूनिक बिकॉज ऑफ इट्स स्पेशल कलर, लाइक इट हैज अ सैफ्रॉन कलर एंड इट हैज अ स्पेशल एरोमा लाइक मस्टर्डी एरोमा, एंड इट इज ड्यू टू द स्पेशल यूनिक कैरेक्टरिस्टिक ऑफ दिस टर्मरिक आर ड्यू टू द सॉइल फीचर्स ऑफ द सांगली डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड इट हैज
ओके,
रिसेंटली गॉट अ जीआई टैग ऑल्सो.
ग्रेट. सो लाइक व्हाट आर द सॉइल फीचर्स व्हिच हेल्प्स इन दिस टर्मरिक प्लांटेशन?
सर, सॉइल फीचर्स लाइक ब्लैक कॉटन सॉइल इज प्रेजेंट इन सांगली डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड दी स्टोरेज सिस्टम यूज्ड टू स्टोर दिस राइजोम्स ऑफ द टर्मरिक इज ऑल्सो रिस्पॉन्सिबल बिकॉज दिस टर्मरिक इज स्टोर्ड अंडरग्राउंड, सो दिस सॉइल प्रॉपर्टीज इम्पार्ट देयर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स इन टू टर्मरिक.
ऑल राइट, ग्रेट. सो लाइक कैन यू प्लीज टेल अस व्हाट इम्पार्ट्स द टर्मरिक द येलो कलर और द सैफरन कलर इन केस ऑफ सांगली टर्मरिक?
सर एग्जैक्टली आई डोंट नो, सॉरी सर.
ऑल राइट, कैन यू प्लीज टेल मी द साइंटिफिक नेम ऑफ टर्मरिक एज यू बिलोंग टू अ एग्रीकल्चरल बैकग्राउंड इन इंजीनियरिंग?
सॉरी सर, आई फॉरगॉट इट.
इट्स ऑल राइट. कैन यू प्लीज गेस दी फैमिली ऑफ टर्मरिक? इट्स ओके, इट्स जिंजर, राइट? इट इज फ्रॉम जिंजर फैमिली, राइट? सो कैन यू प्लीज ऑल्सो टेल अस वॉट आर द एरियाज इन इंडिया अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस महाराष्ट्र रीजन विच प्रोड्यूस टर्मरिक, एंड ऑल्सो विच आर द टॉप थ्री हाइएस्ट प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ टर्मरिक इन द वर्ल्ड इन टर्म्स ऑफ कंट्री?
The turmeric in India, turmeric producing areas in India are apart from Maharashtra are Madhya Pradesh, sorry, Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, or in Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu. Odisha is there. All these.
And which countries are the highest producer of turmeric in the world?
Sir, I don't know exactly, but. Sorry, sir.
It's okay, right? Like, have you heard about the term biopiracy?
Yes, sir.
What it is?
Sir, biopiracy means using the traditional knowledge of the tribal peoples without their proper concern and without giving the proper benefits to them.
Right. So, are you aware of any biopiracy dispute regarding turmeric?
No, sir, not exactly. Sorry, sir.
Okay, it's okay. Right. So, Sangeeta, we can see in a DAP that the profession of your mother is agriculture, but like her income is zero. So, how come income of any profession could be zero?
Sir, actually, I have written her income as zero because on income certificate, the income of my father has only written. Because a whole agricultural property has been registered in my father's name. So I have written like that.
All right. So, have you heard the term feminization of agriculture?
Yes, sir.
What it means?
Sir, the feminization of agriculture means the growing number of female workers in agricultural fields.
Okay. So, what is the reason for this?
Sir, the reason for this, the main reasons are two. One is the out migration of the male member of the family for getting jobs in the urban areas. It is caused due to the agrarian distress in rural areas. And second reason is that the females are not having proper skills and trainings to be employed in the non-farm activities. So they are employed more in agricultural activities.
Right. So, like you also mentioned agricultural distress, and there are some other problems which our agriculture sector is going through.
Yes.
So, Sangeeta, like if we make you the agricultural secretary of India, or rather just say of only Maharashtra, right? Agriculture secretary of Maharashtra, like how will you try to increase the income of farmers? What step will you take? Tell me 1, 2, 3, right?
Yes, sir. We have to reform our agriculture throughout entire supply chain of the agriculture from producer towards the consumer. So the first step I will take to improve the agriculture is to have the proper prices for the agricultural commodities to the farmers. Then I would suggest the scientific practice of the agriculture. And then I would suggest the education and training of the farmers to encourage them to use the advanced practices in agriculture. Then I would also suggest to move towards the integrated farming system, like combining the agricultural crops along with livestock, poultry, and other allied activities like food processing, etc.
Right. So how like can you please tell us very briefly how we can bring the scientific approach to agriculture in our country, given that our farmers are very like relatively poor and small land holders, right?
Yes, sir. First thing to do is the proper soil health management. Then we should provide farmers the improved varieties of seeds so that our crop will be
Here you said we. Who is we here?
we means those who are involved in agriculture. For example, the government should create a new policies in this way. And scientists should develop new varieties of the crops and other administrative machineries from district level to village level. Then KVKs are also there, Krishi Vigyan Kendras. They should disseminate the improved varieties and technologies to the farmers. All these
All right, all
Sunday.
right, all right. So, Sangeeta, my last question to you is, being in touch with the agriculture, you must be aware about the cultural as well as agricultural significance of cow, right? And we are also aware about the importance of tiger in wildlife conservation, right? So recently there has been demand from some people to replace cow as the national animal of our country, right? Instead of tiger. So, what is your take on this issue? Please tell us that along with the justifications.
Sir, please give me 5 seconds.
Please take time.
Yes, sir.
If you don't wish to answer this, you can skip this. It's okay.
Yes, sir, I will skip this.
All right. So, like, I think now, if Paritosh sir is ready, he can ask. Otherwise, Lawrence sir can take over from here, right?
Lawrence can go
Yes.
forward now.
Yes.
Good morning, Sangeeta.
Good morning, sir.
How was your day today?
It was good.
Okay, it was good. What did you do in the morning? What was your morning schedule?
I woke up at 5:30 and then I get ready. And since then, I have been waiting for interview.
Okay. So, Sangeeta, you graduated in, you have a master's degree, right, in agricultural engineering, and you graduated in 2017. What have you been doing since that time?
Sir, I have been preparing for UPSC religiously, only for UPSC.
Okay, so if you had to go for UPSC, then why did you do a master's degree? You could have come after directly after your bachelor's.
Sir, I did post graduation because I thought it will provide me an opportunity to widen my knowledge base. And as I have done post graduation in agricultural engineering, and it is also the subject is also important in forestry also, because many of the subdisciplines of agricultural engineering are related to forestry. So if I get more knowledge, then I would be able to work more efficiently in Indian Forest Service also.
Okay.
And the another reason was that doing M.Tech in Indian Agriculture Research Institute, New Delhi, I thought it will provide me an opportunity for the better preparation of Indian Forest Service. So I opted for M.Tech.
And did it? So this is what your objectives were before going for masters. So in masters, did you get these experiences, or did it really broaden your horizons?
Yes, sir.
What did you learn in masters that you didn't learn in the bachelor's?
Sir, in bachelor's, I learned more theoretical. There was little less emphasis on a practical approach.
Mm-hmm.
So in masters, I learned for that. And in addition to this, in masters, we do research individually. So the sense of independence will come to us. Then also the confidence building, the things I got in M.Tech through the presentation skills and all that.
So what was your research topic?
So my research was on modeling of the hydrological processes in the watershed.
Okay, so I don't know anything about it. Can you explain to me, for example, if you would explain it to someone who doesn't understand it at all, what you actually did in your work?
Sir, in that, I model using software called Hydrus. I model the different hydrological processes like rainfall, runoff, then infiltration, and all these properties I model through Hydrus. And on the basis of that, I calculated the total water yield of the watershed, and then I proposed a plan for the farmers in that watershed to how to use this additional water in the watershed.
In which region was this?
It was in Bundi district of Rajasthan.
Bundi district of Rajasthan. Okay.
Rajasthan.
Okay. So what were the outcomes of the project?
Outcomes were there was sufficient water available in the watershed, but its management was poor. The water was not properly managed in that watershed. So if we practice some water conservation, water harvesting measures in that watershed, then we would be able to conserve this water, and farmers in that region would be able to use that water to grow more crops in that area.
Okay. Sangeeta, why is it important, if you talk about, for example, streams, so why is it important to maintain a certain minimum level of flow in the stream? Okay.
Sir, it is important to conserve the river ecology in the upstream areas of the stream, or downstream areas of the stream, because if minimum water level goes beyond a certain limit, and it will threaten the various plant and animal species in the river. And it is also important for providing enough drinking water and other and water for other activities in the downstream region.
You would have also heard, like, many times people say, like, if water is flowing, it gets purified itself. How can that happen? I mean, if there is pollutant, where will it go if there is pollutant in water, if it is flowing? Have you heard about that before, that flowing water is pure, stagnant water is usually not that good?
Yes, sir. Flowing water purifies itself because it moves. It keeps moving from its source to the destination. And in stagnant water, the water remains stagnant. There is no water incoming or outgoing from that. So pollutants get stagnated in that waters. So that
yeah, that's the meaning of words, stagnant and moving only. Okay. So you see, whenever you get these stagnant conditions, it's not just water. For example, if you look at places in Delhi and all where stagnant conditions develop, even in atmosphere, pollutants will develop. It's because they do not get diluted. Okay, when they are moving, it simply gets diluted because there is a lot of water which comes. Okay. So Sangeeta, in Maharashtra, so where you are present, are there any issues? You already talked about some of the issues of that you are facing in agriculture. Okay, so based on technology, is there anything that you learned in your graduation which you can apply to improve the conditions of agriculture? I'm asking about technology, not the management part. I'm not asking about management, any technology.
Sir, we can use the biopesticides instead of chemical fertilizers.
Okay.
We can promote use of biopesticides in grapes and pomegranate orchards in my district.
Okay. All right, Sangeeta. You would have heard about like the recent developments in Afghanistan.
Yes.
How do you think they are going to affect India?
Sir, the crisis in Afghanistan will affect India in terms of its security, especially in Jammu and Kashmir. Then there will be an issue of the exodus of refugees from Afghanistan to India. Then these are two major issues.
So what should our steps be to safeguard against these issues?
Sir, our stand should be to constructively engage with all the stakeholders of Afghanistan to maintain peace in Afghanistan, so that the whatever whoever comes in power in Afghanistan, they should not promote the terrorist attacks against India. India should confirm this.
Should India recognize legitimacy of the, if Taliban forms the government, should India legitimize or recognize that the legitimacy of that government formed by Taliban?
Sir, if Taliban will not provide their land to be used by the terrorist who makes terror attacks on India, and if the government in Afghanistan would be inclusive as the India stand, and if the human rights of the people and women rights are safeguarded by the Taliban, then India may recognize the government of Taliban in Afghanistan.
Okay, my final question to you would be, have you heard about that the mineral wealth of Afghanistan? It is rich in minerals, right? Yes. Can you name like some of the minerals which could be mined there possibly? And we are also hearing news that China may try to sort of like take advantage of the situation. So if you could comment on that part.
Yes, sir. Afghanistan has the wealth of mineral in some of its parts. And those minerals are the rare earth minerals, and gold is also. So this much I can think of.
Yeah, good. Okay. All right. So that's all from my side. Over to you, Paritosh, sir.
Okay. So, Sangeeta, tell me about the significance of Pandharpur Yatra.
Sir, Pandharpur Yatra is carried out on the Ashadi and Kartiki Purnima, and it has a significance because it has its roots in the Warkari sect, which was the part of Bhakti movement in Maharashtra. And on this, the huge number of people who follow this Warkari sect, they used to migrate from different parts of Maharashtra towards Pandharpur, which is located in the Solapur district of Maharashtra. and the main deity which is revered is the god Vitthala.
What is the significance I had asked? Can you suggest some significance, or because I got the details, I know that you are aware of it. Is there any significance also?
Sir, it has religious significance. Like,
okay, that's fine. Tell me something. You know, Latur has sugarcane cultivations, right?
Yes, sir.
And we always hear that, you know, water trains are going there from MP, from UP. How can that be possible?
Sir, can you repeat your question? Pardon.
Latur is known for its sugarcane cultivation, right?
Yes, sir.
But we always hear that water trains are coming to Latur from MP, from Chhattisgarh, from UP. How can that happen? If sugarcane is being cultivated, that means the area must be rich in water.
Yes, sir. Sir, the area is the Latur area comes under the Marathwada region, which has very less rainfall. And sugarcane is cultivated for their commercial purpose only. And the environmental aspect is not considered at all in that region. So faulty cropping practices are responsible for this. And sugarcane is growing by exploiting the groundwater in that region.
So do you suggest that sugarcane is responsible for the droughts and the scarcity of water in that region?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It is responsible.
But you see, because more and more water is needed, we need more generators, motors. The price of sugarcane cultivation actually goes up. And farmers actually demand that the price, the FRP, which is called of sugar, fair remunerative price, should be consistently increased. And sugar has seen some of the highest increases in the crop MSP. So, how do you think this cycle can be broken? Because the government subsidizes this sugar cultivation more and more, and it is now forced to actually supply water in tankers to the areas which are rich in sugar cultivation. How do you think this can be broken?
This can be, sir. Sir, can you repeat?
How do you think, how can this cycle be broken that farmers are getting more and more remunerative prices, higher prices for exploiting more water resources, polluting water resources, and increasing the pressure on government to keep on increasing the FRP of sugar? So do you think this cycle can be broken? If so, how?
Sir, first I would suggest that the sugarcane is not suitable crop for that region. We should move towards crop diversification, like the oilseed pulses and the horticultural crops can be promoted in that region. And if we are going for sugarcane, it can be grown with the help of drip irrigation also. So I would suggest the suggest for crop diversification in that area.
Have you done your internships after you passed out from agriculture? Like,
no,
did you
sir.
Do any internship? Okay. So you got NCC B and C certificates. Did the absence of A certificate come? Was anywhere you know, you felt like it should have been there? It would have been better.
Certificate A.
Yes.
Sir. I could not do Certificate A NCC because it was not available in my school, because it is granted at UNC. So there was no compulsion to do Certificate A for opting for Certificate B and C examination.
Okay. Who is the current DG of NCC?
Sir, pardon, I'm unable to hear your voice.
Who is the current DG of NCC, Director General of NCC?
सर करंट डायरेक्टर जनरल इज लेफ्टिनेंट जनरल तरुण कुमार एच।
टेल मी द प्रायोरिटीज दैट आर गिवन टू एन एनसीसी सर्टिफिकेट कैंडिडेट्स और बेनिफिट्स दैट आर अकॉर्डेड टू देम.
सर इन इंडियन आर्मी दे आर गिवन प्रिफरेंस देन इट मे कॉन्ट्रीब्यूट टू आवर पर्सनैलिटी डेवलपमेंट। यस सर दिस मच आई कैन थिंक ऑफ।
How has NCC helped you? This is my final question. How has NCC helped you in your life?
Sir, NCC has taught me many values which are important for my personality development also. Like it has the motto of unity and discipline. Then it taught me for the hard work. Then it also promote the unity among the people. Then it also make us familiar about various social issues. Through its blood donation camps and other tree plantation programs, etc.
Okay, that is all from my side, Sangeeta. Over to you, Rishabh, sir.
Good morning, Sangeeta.
Good morning, sir.
So, you studied at IARI, okay? And so, can you tell us about some history of this place?
Sir, it was established in 1903 by the then the governor Lord Curzon. It was first established in the Pusa Bihar, and due to the earthquake happened in Bihar in 1934, it was shifted to New Delhi in 1936. So this much.
Okay. So suppose I reach the New Delhi station, okay, and now I have to go Pusa. So can you suggest me three modes through which I can go there? What are the routes and what are the modes we can take?
Sir, you can go using a metro through New Delhi metro station to Raju Chowk and then to Rajendra Place. You can go by Ola or Uber. You can also go by daily transport buses. These are the three modes.
Okay, very good. So, can you tell me three things which you liked about Delhi?
Sir, first thing is our own campus, campus of Indian Agricultural Research Institute. Then the Delhi Metro, it was good. And third is the India Gate and campus around it.
Okay, and the three things which you didn't like in Delhi.
Sir, first is Delhi pollution. Then the traffic congestion in Delhi while going by roads. And the crowded markets of Delhi.
Okay, and can you suggest some things which you want to borrow from Delhi and take it to your hometown in Sangli?
Sir, sweaters are comparatively cheap in Delhi.
Come again, what?
Sir, sweaters we wear during winter.
Okay. Woolen cloths, you are saying?
Yes, sir, woolen.
And other things which you liked in Delhi and you want to take it to your hometown?
Sir, I'm
okay. Okay, no issues. Can you tell us about what is this biodiversity hotspot?
Sir, biodiversity hotspots are the areas with high species richness, and there is also high threats to the existing species.
Are there any hotspot in our country?
So there are three hotspots. First is Western Ghat, then comes Eastern Himalayas, and then Indo-Burma region.
Okay, and can you tell us who is the governor of your state?
So governor is Honorable Shri Bhagat Singh Koshyari.
Okay, and you wrote your hobby is reading. Can you tell us about it? What kind of books do you read?
Sir, I read Marathi novels.
Okay, and fiction, non-fiction?
Both, sir. Both.
Okay, so can you suggest us few important few novels which you liked?
The first is Panipat, written by Vishwas Patil. Then
Okay.
comes the Chhawa novel written by Shivaji Sawant.
Okay.
And yes, sir.
So, can you tell me when was this first battle of Panipat fought?
It was fought on 1526
Between?
between Babur and the Ahmad Shah Abdali.
Oh, okay, no problem. And can you tell us about second battle?
Second battle, it was happened on 1556 between the Akbar and the I'm unable to recall it.
Oh, no problem, Sangeeta. Oh, no problem. Chalo. So that's all from my side. Mayank sir, if you want to continue, you can take over from here.
Nee, I think we can end the interview. You skipped one question earlier regarding whether we should make cow the national animal of our country. So if you wish to attempt it now, you can attempt it. Otherwise, we'll end the interview. It's all right.
Sir, I will read more about it. I'm not aware
All
much
right, all
about
right. All right, Sangeeta. So we can end your interview. You are like, right? So your interview is over. You can please leave the call for a few minutes. Then we'll call you back for the feedback, right? Thank you.
Okay, sir. Okay, thank you, sir.